guys, welcome back to Dreamer Learner Maker. My name is Isadora, and today we're building the Crayola TCR10S 3D printer. We bought this online, and it was shipped from Shenzhen, China to Hong Kong, and we received it 3 weeks later. So, and this is my first 3D printer I've ever owned. So let's open it. Hopefully it really is a 3D printer and not a bunch of papers. Okay, this. It has the base and platform. Take this whole thing out. I'm nervous. It has a small parts box, a controller, some tape, If you're in Asia, you can leave it to 220 volts. But if you're in the US, you have to change it to 110. There's going to be a little tiny rectangle, and use something small like scissors to poke into that and then slip down. In this whole toolbox thing, it has a USB line, some of the tools, it has a tie, the snip, and those has a needle to clean out the nozzle if it's stuck. The USB drive, some extra filaments, the material, the filament shelf, the filament support frame. The decorative, I think. The design, the receiving tool. It kind of looks like a spatula. Power line. The rack screws. And the spare parts. Yeah. Now that we've cleaned the workspace, only the tools and parts remain and the instructions. In the printed instructions, it says instantly to go to screwing. But I want to check the wheels to see if they move the plate. And if we already do that, it's going to be really hard to find the problem. So carefully, since this is working, turn it around. Yeah. On the wheels, do it by row. So first, use your finger and spin this. See if it actually moves it. Nope, it doesn't. So we're going to have to tighten that. And this one, yeah, it's good. This one, these two need tightening. Nope. Yeah. Enough. Okay. Get the double-sided wrench and turn this clockwise. Now that we've got most of it done, now install the riser. The stepper motor should be facing the back and the extruder should be facing the front towards you. Good. I couldn't finish it all last night, so let's continue. Now let's install the Z-axis stator and the Z-axis limit switch. Stator limit switch. make sure all the T-screws are loose. And when you're sure, make them all into a T-shape. Like this. Okay, this one goes on your left. Make sure you have one that matches. Now let's install the next one. You can see from this side if the T-nut had turned around. Okay. You can now install the filament detector. It goes right here. You just snap it on. You can also connect the two. Yeah, right here. The other end of the tube, right here. Good. Before I move on to the wiring, remember to check if all the wheels and nuts and bolts are tight. I heard that the stepper motors can be really noisy, so about this. Since we're only building the ones that come in the box with the Creality, I'll show you how to build this in the next video. Before we start connecting, I want to point out something. This is the Y-axis. It goes back and forth. This is the Y-axis stepper motor. And then this is the X-axis. It takes the nozzle or hot end back and forth. This. And then this is the Z-axis. These are the Z-axis stepper motors. It takes it up and down. And this is the E stepper motor. It stands for extruder. It takes the filament and pushes it along the wire into the hot end where it prints. And then two more things. First is that usually four wires is for the stepper motors, like this. Yeah. And then the two wires is for the limit switches. And then the last thing before we start connecting is this. This is the filament detector wire. It has a board on it, and this board is for if you don't want to use a filament detector, you can keep it on. But if you do want to use a filament detector, you can take the board off and then connect it here. Remember to set your voltage, and you might blow something up if you don't do it. 110 for US and 220 for Asia or Europe. Remember that or you might explode something. Yeah. Before we power it up, remember, do not, never directly print anything on top of the heat bed. You can either use the glass that comes with it, or a separately box thing. This. My dad bought it for me, and it's supposed to work better. But I'm going to test it out in another video. Okay. Before I actually turn it on, I have two important tips. One, it doesn't hurt to double check that it doesn't have any bubbles and this flat. And if you can use this to scrape up the bubbles if you have the spatula guy. Scrape it. Yeah. The second important tip is that we found out that the hot end and glass were making contact with each other. And I'm glad I didn't turn it on directly, because if I auto-homed it, it might scratch the glass and damage the hot end. So, also, I found that turning it counterclockwise on the bottom of the platform is making more gap between the nozzle hot end thing, and also the glass. Make more. Now let's boot it up and start printing. Okay, now we can auto-home it. Here, and then auto-home. And there. Now that we've auto-homed it, we can bed auto-leveling. Do this. And then next step. Here, okay. Okay, corner one. Put it under. Make sure the paper is barely touching the hot end. But counterclockwise is to make it further away, and clockwise is to make it closer. One is go to control and then temperature. There, and then nozzle embed. The other way is to go to prepare and then to scroll down and then I'll say preheat PLA. This is the target temperature for the hot end and the current temperature for the hot end too. This is the target temperature for the heat bed, and this is the current temperature for the heat bed. This is the progress of how it's printing, and this is the how fast it is printing. We're waiting. You can now install the filament holder. Now that the filament's in, you can now take your SD card, turn it around, and slip it into the SD slot. Make sure it's upside down. Then it's in there. Ah. SD. And SD. And TSC. Print from SD. And then cat. Start to bed heating. Have to wait until it heats. Yes. Thank you. very 3D printer to print objects. That's why I've always wanted to have my own 3D printer. The 3D printer is easier to build than you may think. It is more like taking it out of the box, follow instructions, and then start building. The first 3D object I have ever printed on this new machine is a cat. The cat is so smooth and lots more details than the one I printed from the library. Priority did a good job on this machine. Thanks. I learned a lot about 3D printing and 3D printers while I was building this machine. I spent lots of effort on making this video. If you enjoyed it, please thumbs up and click the subscribe button down below. Happy printing and see you in the next video.